Hello, welcome to the Great Outdoors RV. My name is Mate, and today we are going to check out the Cedar Creek Silverback Edition. This is the 29RE fifth wheel. Some overall specs on this particular camper is the dry weight of it is 10,682 pounds. This also has a GVWR of 13,985 pounds. This is 33 foot 11 inches, 67 fresh water capacity, 80 gallons gray water and 40 gallons black water. To start off, I want to tell you a little bit about the construction of the Cedar Creek, since that is probably the number one reason why people buy a Cedar Creek is because of their construction as well as their customer satisfaction rating. This has a 5/8 inch tongue and groove plywood decking throughout the floor. In fact, you can even see that through the pass-through storage here. So not only is the floor above the bedroom, but it is also above the living room, all 5/8 inch. This also has one of the best insulation packages available as well. You'll also notice underneath here, it's all aluminum construction. So it has a stud every 16 inches, just like a house, and an additional frame around every single door and window. This is also a non-welded camper. So as you see inside here, this is all put together with Siliprene, with L brackets that are screwed together, that will give you a lot of strength and flexibility as you're pulling this down the road. There's also hurricane straps that connect the ceiling to the walls that give you a lot of flex and strength as well. This is a hung wall. This is a type of gel coat wall that is non-laminated. There's only a very few set of coaches that build it like this in the industry. The benefit of that is you don't have to worry about that wall separating or delaminating over time because of that. So that's a huge advantage to you. This also has a fully enclosed underbelly, 12 volt heat pads on the tanks themselves, extra insulation in the ceiling and the floor and the sidewalls. So this has the dead air space type of insulation because it's a non-laminated wall. Instead of block foam, this is the type of like fuzzy type of insulation that you would have in your home. To point out a few other features inside here, you'll notice all your tank valves for your dump valves are all enclosed inside your underbelly. It's very easy to access all the valves to winterize your coach as well for the bypass behind the water heater. This is a 10 gallon water heater that gives you both gas and electric and DSI that can give you up to 16.2 gallons of hot water per hour. You also have a hydraulic system to run the slide outs, and this is kind of nice because usually a hydraulic system, it's one button to get all the slides in and out. Unfortunately, with hydraulic systems, that means even if you want your biggest slide out, you have to put out all the smaller slides as well. With this system here, you can turn on and off those, so you can put just out one slide out and you're good to go. You also have a battery disconnect. This disconnects the battery so that while you're in storage, you're not gonna have to worry about your batteries drawing down. You also have auto level. So this has the 6-point auto level system, which is a little bit more stable and a little bit more useful than the 4-point auto level system. Sometimes a coach this size at 34 feet, full profile, the 4-point can give you some hassle. The 6-point is good to go. This has the easy reel. This has a 50 amp cord with it. So it's a very thick, very heavy cord so that you can run two ACs at the same time. And it's nice to be able to roll that up instead of having to manhandle this giant piece of wire. You'll also notice this is a very thick luggage door with the metal instead of plastic deal here. So a lot of times these break if they're plastic, but this is gonna last a lot longer. Another thing to point out is this has the box for the furnace. So instead of having to take apart a lot of cabinetry to access the furnace, it's a matter of four screws, and that's gonna cut down on labor costs as far as being able to maintenance that. On the front of the coach, you'll notice that these ends are cut in, so if you do have a short bed truck, this will be a little bit easier to make a nice turning radius without having to hit the cap and slide your slider hitch back. As you can see, you do have some good storage underneath here. And again, this is that plywood decking that you see throughout the coach. A lot of times they'll wrap those in the competition to hide the fact that they're using chipboard. In fact, they'll even have a different name for that OSB chipboard so they don't have to say that word. The reason why that's bad is even though you can have a one piece of chipboard, as soon as you get that wet, that can end up having problems where the glue fails and it just, you have a lot of cupping and bowing where the floor just will give way. You can imagine replacing a subfloor in a camper is a monstrous job that will pretty much total out the coach a lot of times. You also have outside speakers, frameless windows, an awning that's a power awning that has the metal wrap around it. That's a super nice feature so that, especially here in Colorado where the sun is very harsh, a lot of times you'll get little pinholes and it will crack that first foot of awning, and that can make, of course, you know, another $500 down the tube trying to replace that awning fabric every couple years. This will make it last a lot longer. You'll also notice that there's a nice wrap around the corner of the roof. What that allows you to do is not have a spot where it's as much susceptible to leaking over time. By putting that corner around the edge like they do here, and doing that same thing on the roof, that will just make your coach that much better over time. You also have a spray port over here, which is a new feature that they've recently added. This is super nice to be able to rinse off your patio, your picnic table, your steps, all from this port right here. You also have one on the other side as well. These are the super nice stairs that they're solid steps. So these just fold right into the coach and they feel a lot more solid as you're walking up it. And you have an extra long extended grab assist handle. A few other things that I want to mention on the rear of the coach. One, it does have a spot to add a backup camera if you decide to do that, as well as a ladder to climb up on top of the roof to be able to clear off those slide outs. And this happens to have the gabled slide out for one of the slide outs as well, which is really nice for both the bedroom area and the dinette side in the living room. Another thing that I wanted to mention is this has the extra nice Easy Flex suspension system. That is going to give you a much smoother ride for not only all the stuff inside your camper, all the components inside your camper, the structure and frame of the camper, as well as a smooth ride just pulling it from your truck. All right, come on inside. I'll show you some of the different things on the inside that you might like. One, you'll notice that this does have opposing slide outs across. So this makes this room feel very open. And this has, of course, the rear entertainment, two Lazy Boy recliners across here. These are movable. So if you want to be able to get a little bit better view of the TV, you can do that. Lazy Boy, they do have a few extra features that is kind of nice because those are exclusive to Forest River. One thing is that clicking noise that you hear, that means you can put your feet up at halfway instead of all the way, which is an exclusive feature to Lazy Boy. Another thing that's really cool is if you look underneath here, there's a piece of wood here. A lot of times that is open on other brands, and that just makes it so that the chair can fall apart over time. One other feature is you can put the back down without having to put your feet up. Again, a feature that you can only have on a Lazy Boy. And then last is there is some wing nuts back here. So if you wanna make this, if you're, you know, a lighter person or a heavier person, and you wanna make this back, lean back easier or harder, you can adjust those wing nuts and be able to do that. So a lot of really neat features for a Lazy Boy. All LED lights throughout. This is a 8 cubic foot gas electric refrigerator. We chose that because if you are traveling down the road and you want to be able to keep your food cold during that time, this is a great way to do that. You can also do an electric option only with an inverter, but those batteries will wear out fairly quickly just because anytime you're running, trying to get something cold or hot, that's a lot of electricity to perform that. You do have storage underneath the chairs here. This does pull out, so if you want an extra leaf to get some elbow room, you have it. And then, let's see here, the way this works is these come off, and then there is a sofa sleeper in here, and this does make into a bed. You also have a fireplace, a Jensen television. You also have the ducted whisper quiet air conditioning system. So what that does is instead of having the box right here and it being really noisy while you're watching TV or the game or a movie, it has more of like a home style AC system where the AC is actually all the way on top of the roof instead of partway into your living room. And that makes it about half the noise level. A couple other options in the kitchen to point out. One, it does have a full-size microwave, which doesn't sound like a big deal until you try to put a full-size dinner plate in one of those smaller ones. That's where that can really come in handy. You do have a three-burner stove, as well as a large oven here. These are all on the nice glide system, so as you push in that last inch, it will push in itself. That way, if you're bouncing down the road and the cupboard comes open just a hair, it's gonna push itself back in. You also have a pull-down sink faucet, a stainless steel sink, 50-50 split on that. And then lots of drawers to work with, lots of cabinetry to work with. You also notice if you can, these are all hidden hinges, as well as pocket screwed together with a piece of pine wood for all your wood styles. Raised panel cabinetry on the fronts as well, and then really nice crown molding throughout. This has the high powered Max Air, or I'm sorry, Creative Breeze Fantastic Fan with rain sensor built into the unit, as well as double ducted air conditioning, so it cools down your unit more evenly. This is also one that has a barreled ceiling, which kind of gives that more open feeling to it. Unfortunately, they are going away from a couple things to save some cost. We've had lots of rising costs. So one of the things that they're going to eliminate on this in future models is the awesome cathedral slide out where you have this gabled side on here, which is a little sad, and they're going away from the barreled ceiling. Again, just to try to keep their price point the same because of the different things going on in the industry. You also have two air conditioners built onto this unit, Dometic style deal here where it's a digital thermostat. So you can control both of those for both your heat and cool through the same system, just like you would at home. This is how you can control the fantastic vent fan, so it'll automatically close if it gets to a certain temperature or if it starts to rain. This unit also has a cool feature where on top of the unit, it has a spot to add a solar panel. So that's already prepped out, the wires are already ran. So if you decide to add solar, it's a low cost compared to having to, because that's where a lot of your labor comes from. You also have this feature right here, this is an LCI panel, and you can watch videos on how to do different things on your camper, as well as a control panel. So like if you wanted to control your 6-point auto level, you could do that from this system. Forest River has a lot of great how-to videos on how to do a lot of different things here, and we also have that on our website. So if you go to thegreatoutdoorsrv.com and click on parts and service, you can see a lot of how-to videos that I've done to talk about your fridge, your stabilization system, leveling, your air conditioner, all kinds of the nitty-gritty type stuff. I've done videos on each one of those things. Coming into the bathroom, solid surface countertops, just like you have in your kitchen area. Porcelain commode instead of a plastic one. Another high-powered Creative Breeze Fantastic Fan. Skylight here, and you'll notice I have sitting room here to be able to do whatever. Medicine cabinet, as well as a linen closet over on this side. Again, they haven't cheapened out the cabinetry in the bathroom or bedroom area, whereas a lot of places what they'll do is they'll put a really nice cabinet on the kitchen one, and you're like, oh, it has all super nice cabinetry throughout. And really, it's like two or three cabinets, and the rest is all the not so good cabinets. Moving on to the bedroom area, this is a king size bed. You'll notice I have walk around room and a kind of a little coat closet slash changing area if you need it right there on the side. This gabled slide out is going away as well, unfortunately. This does have the whisper quiet AC. That's another thing that I feel like Cedar Creek has done a good job on this camper. Sometimes they'll have the whisper quiet AC maybe in the living room, but when it comes to the bedroom, they'll just put a normal box AC since that's sometimes just an option, whereas Cedar Creek has finished that off nicely. You do have the second TV that comes with the unit for the bedroom. Emergency exit if you want to. This is an openable window. And you'll notice it's a rain style window as opposed to the kind that just lift up and down. That means if it starts raining, you're not gonna get that wood harmed. And then these windows are also openable. So a spot to put like your cell phone or whatever, pull down shades, and then you can get a nice cross breeze. You do have power outlets on both sides of this bed. Over here in the closet, you do have washer dryer prep inside here, as well as a spot for lots of shoes and hanging whatever. And then this is liftable, so if you want to be able to put maybe an extra blanket or pillow underneath there, you can do that as well. So that is the Silverback 29RE. If this is the right coach for you, great. You should also check out the Silverback 29IK if you like this floor plan, but you want an island kitchen. That's another really good floor plan to look at. That's similar cost, very similar construction, very similar features. If you have any questions, you can reach us at 970-313-4337. If you like the video, hit the like button. If you hit the subscribe button, you can see all of our videos up and coming of all the different changes. Like I said, some are good, some are bad, and those will all be coming in the next several months here as we kind of get in our new units that are kind of replacing these current ones. You can also go to our website, thegreatoutdoorsrv.com, and check out all the different floor plans. We've taken probably 20 to 50 pictures of each camper, done a video on them, put a description. We also put like an options page, the MSRP sheet to show you all that, and our sale price on this one as well as all of our other campers. We're one of the few dealerships. There's two different ways to go about that. One is call for price. What we do is we like to give you the price up front. We also take trade-ins, we also do financing. We're set up with a ton of different banks so we can get very aggressive rates from the different banks and very long term. So if you're spending $50,000, you can plan on maybe $500 a month if you're a A plus credit type of customer. And of course that can vary depending on your credit score. If you have any questions about financing, just want to figure out where you're at, what the payment would be, give us a call. We're happy to help you out with that. Thanks guys, have a great day.